pies. A favorite any time of the year. But when the weather turns cold, they are one of the best comfort foods around. And today we're making a fall favorite with the help from the pie shop in Buckhead. Joanne Feldman is standing by to learn the secret to making a savory pumpkin pie.
Yum.
Oh, do tell.
Yeah, this is killing me over here. I've been smelling this for a while. Yeah, really good pies. And joining me again this morning is Mims Bledsoe from the pie shop in Buckhead. Oh, my goodness. We had the chili cornbread pie last segment.
We did chili cornbread earlier.
Now we're going traditional. We want to know about the pumpkin pie, and you do all kinds of pies in your shop. I mean, what's the most unusual combination you've come up with so far?
Oh, goodness. Well, probably, definitely this time of year, the apple bacon pie is going to be a big favorite. And so we've done quite a few of those. This summer we did an orange creamsicle pie. We do custom pies, and so we can always do something a little different if you've got a request.
Take suggestions. All right. Wheels are turning now. All right. What's the secret to a perfect pumpkin pie here?
Well, really, you've got to start with fresh roasting the pumpkins.
Okay.
So you can actually get these in the store right now. These are either called sugar pumpkins or pie pumpkins. They're smaller than the ones that you would use for a jack-o'-lantern. But the easiest way to roast a pumpkin is just to slice it in half. Butter some tin foil and then cover each side. Place it face up in the oven at about 375 for about 35 minutes, and all of those juices get retained. And then you scrape out the seeds and the fibers, mm-hmm. and what you're left with is a really nice tender pumpkin meat.
All right, so we're not cheating here. No canned pumpkin filling.
And if you've never had fresh pumpkin pie, it's a totally different experience mm-hmm. than the canned variety. After you've got the meat scraped out of the shells, then you put it in a food processor and you process it just until all the lumps are gone.
Okay.
You've got a real smooth consistency.
Mm-hmm.
And this is really your basis for pumpkin pie. So 2 cups of pumpkin puree.
Okay.
You've got all of your sugars and spices. So you've got 2/3 cup light brown sugar, 1/3 cup sugar, 1 tablespoon of flour. You've got 1/4 teaspoon salt, as well as 1 teaspoon cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon nutmeg, 1/2 teaspoon ginger.
Mm-hmm. That's what I'm smelling right now, is the cinnamon and the nutmeg and the ginger, yep.
And then to top it off, just 1/4 teaspoon of allspice.
Okay.
And then 2 eggs, already together is your dairy, which is 1/3 cup of milk, as well as, or 1/3 cup of heavy cream, as well as 1 cup of milk.
Okay.
And then 1.5 teaspoons of vanilla extract,
okay.
pure vanilla.
So you're going to mix all of that together.
That's exactly right. First, you blend your dry ingredients all together. If you don't blend the dry ingredients first, then you'll get patches of different spices. So you want to make sure that these are well combined.
Don't want any surprises in the middle of a bite.
That's exactly right. Oh, that was a lot of nutmeg.
Yeah. Okay.
And then just lightly beat the eggs.
Mm-hmm. And you're going to mix that in with the cream and then the puree. And
that's exactly right.
And put it in the pie crust. All right, I want to get a taste of the, the final result. I'm getting impatient here. You've got one over there. Well, go ahead with what you're doing right here.
All right. You're just going to want to combine them all together. And then the final result, actually, I've already got an example.
Okay.
It looks just like this. It's
pretty
liquid, you can see. And then you place it in the oven at about 375 for about 45 minutes, just until it's loose in the center. You want to pull it out before it's completely firm,
and
because it continues
like
to bake after you take it out.
I'm armed with my fork.
And
I'm just going to stick it right in the middle, can I? We don't have to be pretty here about this.
Fresh roasted pumpkin pie.
Oh, my goodness. That does make a difference. I don't think I've ever had the real thing. That is fantastic.
And top it with a little whipped cream or ice cream, and you've got the perfect Thanksgiving treat.
Oh, it is perfect. I'm sure Thanksgiving is a very busy time of year for you. You're taking orders, though.
That's exactly right.
All right.
The website, we're already taking orders for Thanksgiving. So if this looks like too much work for you, we're happy to do the baking for you.
Very good. Well, if you want more information on how to do this yourself or more information on the pie shop, you can go to myfoxatlanta.com. And if you click on the Good Day tab, you're going to find all the information right there. Karen, I might save you some over here.
Did you say might?
Maybe.
You might save us some. Come on, Joanne.